More protests are expected in Venezuela today. Juan Guaido, the country's self-proclaimed leader, is calling for his supporters to take to the streets again to step up pressure on President Nicolas Maduro and demand new elections. Maduro has also called on his supporters to rally today. The power struggle between Guaido and Maduro has brought the country to a standstill, and that as a huge electricity blackout has paralyzed much of the country. DW's Oscar Schlenker is in the capital, Caracas, and he joins me now by phone. Oscar, what caused the power cut?
Well, there are reports from the electrical company that a fire broke out in one of the lines of the Guri hydroelectric plant, and that led to a domino effect that affected the entire system. But this is not something new or that surprises anybody in Venezuela. The government has been alerted of the risk of not maintaining in optimal conditions this plant. In fact, if it was a U.S.-based sabotage, as the government has said, then they have been planning it for years, because in 2010, Hugo Chavez gave out billions of dollars in concessions to build thermoelectric plants, and none of those are operational today. Most of the grid is plugged into Guri, so if that fails, 70% of the country is blacked out, and this has happened before. Maracaibo, the second largest city, has been weeks without electricity in the past year, and outages like this one have been happening all over the country for years, but never at the magnitude we've seen in the last few days, where the whole country was wiped out.
Will these power cuts, I mean, embolden demonstrators to take to the streets?
Well, people are very angry and frustrated, regardless of whether they believe or not the allegations of a U.S. sabotage. It has taken too long to fix. Many in Caracas are still without electricity. There have been casualties due to this power outage, especially in hospitals where there are many people who have lost people that were very sick or connected to some kind of electrical appliance. So there has been a loss of also electrical appliances, perishable food items. So this is just a confirmation to all people that are supporting Juan Guaido. I think that every protest he's called for attracts huge masses, and today will not be any different. The difference is that the location of the concentration is a traditional Chavista area of Caracas, very close to the government offices, and that could bring up some violence or repression if the location is not changed in the last minute, which I predict it might be. And let's not forget, there's also a pro-Maduro demonstration in the works today, although very little information has been given out about it.
Oscar Schlenker in the capital, Caracas, thank you very much for that analysis.